Okay, so moving on to creative media part B. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be talking a little bit about theories, ladies and gents. That's theory. So with a theory, what we get is an opinion that someone has as to the reason why something happens. So we're going to be talking about the reasons why the media either do control us or don't control us. And we're going to be talking about different types of audiences. Right, so first of all, target audiences. Now, ladies and gents, target audiences are what companies think about when they're trying to market things at us. They'll be thinking about, should we market it towards elderly people? Should we market this towards young people? Shall we market it towards people who use YouTube? Okay, they might look at the ages, they might look at the general likes and dislikes of what people like to do, and really start thinking about the general differences that people have. Because when you think about it, you have very different likes to your brothers, sisters, aunts, uncles. Generally, we all have different likes and dislikes, and we all find people that are into what we're into, that like what we like, and you know, that is a target audience. Okay, so basically there are different types of audiences. We have primary and we have secondary audiences. Probably one of the best examples you can give here is if you are making a program for young people. When I say young, I'm talking super young. I'm talking about, say, 3 to 7 year olds. They might be into your kind of CBeebies type stuff. Possibly they will really have a tendency to like something like Sesame Street. When they're sitting there and they're watching it, they are the primary audience. Sesame Street has been designed for young people, for children. Things on CBeebies have been designed for young people, for babies in particular. So of course, when they're being designed, they thought about the fact that they have to use language, they have to use sounds, they have to use colours, things that younger people will find to be something they like, something they find to be something that's quite attractive, something that makes them feel quite easy about life generally. Now as they're sitting there watching it, there's something called a secondary audience. And now this, what we get with a secondary audience is we'll get people who are maybe their parents, they could be their older sisters, uncles, aunts, who would also be around and also watching it. Now these people weren't the target audience. Sesame Street is not designed for grown-ups. But there's probably a chance that they'll be around when it's on, and in that way, they become the secondary audience.